Okay, let us. Oh, let us get into this. The end of Throne of Ball. I'm not a fan. You've seen Delicious in Dungeon and you hate anime. Nice. I hope you enjoyed it. I thought it was good. It's not as cozy as like Frieren is, but I thought it was really good. I think they've already got it set up for another season too. Oh, we have thieves coming at us. They're attacking Swell and just missing. Funny. Welcome back, Ewell. Oh, more thieves. Oh, that's funny. They come to attack us and Devon's bard song confused them. Rove. Why? Why are you trying to fist the enemy rogues? That's right, you magic him. These things, yeah, I'm not even gonna bother looting these guys. We're past the point of, I think, shops. Had to clean the cat's water bowl. Always a fun time, making sure they got the fresh drinkies. There's a confused thief here, but we don't know it. Okay. Throne is relatively new and seems to be too big for a dwarf to sit in. Wow, this dude running this place definitely has his head up his own ass, huh? He kept going after your mage. Thankfully, Rope has stone skin, so they can attempt to beat on him all they want, but they're not gonna do anything before he turns him into pudding.
It is a shame that you must resort to violence.
I suppose I got some time to kill.
Do I have more darts? Only 40. Uh-oh. That bodes ill for Rove. That, or maybe I'll actually have him start using some of his good darts, I don't know. They did announce the next season, hell yeah. I keep hoping and I keep checking for the announcement of another season for Freer, and there's gotta be one. But what worries me is that they're gonna get a different art studio to do it, and it's going to be like going from season one of One Punch Man to season two of One Punch Man, where you've got this beautiful, well animated thing, and then it's just turned into something that's choppy as fuck. Oh, there's more of them. Where are they? I hear them swinging.
Take no prisoners.
Guys, kill the thief. Oh, we have a bedroom.
May I help?
Chunk, that's on you.
No trouble at all.
Ah, shit. Well, well, what do we have here? To whom do I owe the pleasure of this visit? I am called Swell. Wait a minute, no, no, no. I'm Swell! Who are you? I am Lord Chamberlain Marketh. I am responsible for making sure that New Dorne's Deep runs efficiently, among other things. Even if you have to crush a few gnomes into the ground to do it, eh? My superior needs something done, it must be done, whatever the cost. I don't have the luxury or time to be burdened with ethics. Oh boy. Have you ever stopped to consider that the possibility that your superior is evil? Oh, here it comes. You're grinding up people and destroying their lives, blah blah, the children, blah blah blah. I didn't claw my way to the top of the heap just to be taken down by something as pathetic as moral sentiment. Give it a rest.
I won't give it a rest. You'll pay for what you've done.
Guess what, Goody Tums? Goody Tums, that's certainly one of the names of all time. If you think I'm going to stick around to watch you do a dramatic vengeance dance for me, you're wrong. Farewell, idiot.
You don't get it, do you, Marketh? I came for your badge. You're not going anywhere until you hand it over.
You know, you look like a reasonable person. I'm just a thief. I'm not looking for a fight. I don't suppose there's a chance you just take it and let me go, is there?
No, no chance at all. Your time has come, Marketh.
Very well, if you're so anxious for death, come and get it.
Like,
these are kind of crap fights. Not because they're difficult, but because it's like, this is one thief. Okay, all right, less bitching. We've got random mages. Wait a minute. Kraken Society, isn't that like a front for... fuck. Kibitz. In the old Gold Box games, weren't there people with Kraken tattoos? Who was that? Wasn't that like the fucking Black Network or something? Things not to say to a paladin, right? Goody Tums is a good choice for Swell's new nickname. Oh man. He'd be having words over that one. Can we stun him? Oh, did we stun him? I think he made his save. God damn it. All right, everybody get doing your violence. And this guy is a mage duel. No. Whoa. Somebody named Seth just backstabbed Devon for 55 damage. That's not very nice. No, you fucking angry hobbit. Leave him alone. Here, cast mirror image. There we go. Devon is safe. And this guy's confused. Devon's just watching these two, like, slap fight at each other. Oh, he's got stone skin too now. All right. Greater Malaysian. It's on. Trollish fortitude.
I got places to go.
Slap fight of the century going on here. Oh! Oh, it's on!
I know the routine. Show me a target and I'll smash it.
Flee in terror from Rove! Oh, magic punctures stone skin, huh? Well, that makes this an easy fight. Did he run? No, he's dead. Okay, he was just hiding in the corner. I do like the slap fights between mages. Mage, you'll just channel your actual friend. Man! I don't want to spoil, but that fight with her and Fern and the construct in like the last episode or two is so fucking good. Just like as a spectacle, it's nuts. 50% chance of dealing a D3 electrical damage. I mean, that's not too terrible. AC6 bracers and a robe of infusing. Plus 2 AC magic resistance. One extra 5th level spell slot. Holy shit, don't spend it all in one place. Okay, I'm sure there's goodies in here. What about that other dude? Where's Seth? Yeah. I'm sure Seth's probably got some goodies on him. Oh no, this isn't Seth. This is the other thief whose name I've already forgotten. Throw some of this crap away so we have room to pick things up. So much garbage. Should I fear and told my basic combat spells are enough for today, mages? Yeah, no kidding. Oh! We got his badge and apparently got 150k XP for that. Neat! Level up. 5th level spell for Devon. That's something. I don't think he really has anything to domination and animate dead. Sure. That's probably not going to get used. Is that? Oh, it's a scimitar. Valiant plus 2, one extra attack around. That's real good. Ring of the Gorgon. Wearer is turned to stone. Bro. Dick move. And then just a plus 1 Akizashi. Black Dragon Scale Mails. AC4. So this is like legit just art. This is non-magical armor made of Black Dragon Scales. Acid resistance, save versus spells. Alright. Kinda garbo. I do appreciate that. No, we're keeping this axe. I do appreciate that the game, when looking for quest items, it's smart enough to look in the bag of holding, so I don't have to have it like clogging up inventories. So this.
50% chance, 5%. I think he's gonna take a penalty to attack with this. No. All right. Well, he's taking Valiant then. He's dropping his katana for a scimitar. Technically a scimitar Wakizashi Ninja Toe, which I think he has tier 2 proficiency with. Yes, same as his katana. All right. Neat.
Ready. Sure.
Upgrades. Yes, Chunk is apparently good with scimitars. I had him using one, I think, in the early game for quite a while. What is this? Studded leather plus 2. Small shield plus 1. Gauntlets of Elven Might, not usable by fucking clerics. And you have to be a multi or dual classed fighter. So these go to Chunk, actually. But his strength is already higher because he's got the gauntlets of... Oh no, he's using gauntlets of weapons skill. Plus 1 AC, plus 1 saves, 1851. What's his strength? I think his strength is higher than 18. Yeah, his strength is higher than an 1851, so this is just vendor trash. God, that's a fucking disappointing item. The Salamander's Tongue. It's a plus 3 dagger with a bit of extra fire damage and some save bonuses. Man. Good with scimitars? But he's a dwarf, so it's okay, because it's cool. Now, the dwarf I remember really liking in, if you want to go like Drist, I mean, everybody loves Thibbledorf Quent, the Battle Rager. He wore spiky armor, and his whole combat strategy was like, I'm going to jump on a fucker and have a seizure. But no, the one I really liked, there was a dwarf in... Oh, Rogue just died. Wonderful. There was a dwarf in, I think it was the Artemis and Trere books. It was like Artemis Jarlaxle, and they had a dwarf with him. I don't remember him, but I remember, I think he dual wielded flails, and I think that's pretty cool. That's an interesting weapon combo. You don't see that very often. Stared real hard at Fallout New Vegas, but you didn't bite. That game, I really like Fallout New Vegas, but holy shit, it has not aged well. Like, damn. But yeah, the summer sale, I think I mentioned it. Like, I spent like $20 this year, and that's... Even some of that was a stretch. But I was like, eh, why not? Potion of Freedom. Potion of Explosions. All right, I think that's like a fireball. Golem building book. Oh, magic short sword. There's a bunch of garbage potions in here. All right, I think it's probably just... Oh no, okay. I was gonna say, this might not be great. Short sword of health plus 4. That's pretty good. I think we have one of those, don't we? Don't we have one of those kicking around? I seem to remember us finding something else that would, like, heal when we smacked a fucker with it. But nobody in the party is proficient with short swords, so I don't give a shit. Hey, Schmoop, good to see ya. Hope you're doing well. This game you bought was Baldur's Gate 3 because people talked you into playing it. I'm sorry, Selt. I'm sorry. I hope you gave up in time to get the Steam refund. Whatever Warlord's Battlecry. Warlord's 3 Battlecry. Man! I grew up playing the Warlord's Battlecry games. Those games, I liked those better than Warcraft 2. Then Warcraft 3 happened and all was lost. Now, the Warlord's Battlecry games are good. I liked Warlord's 2, admittedly. So what is this? Appears to be a manual detailing Melavon's construction of 2 iron golems, as well as a number of strange phrases that appear to be command words. Oh, really? Well, that might be useful. How many millions of ill-advised monsters have we slain today? Mostly just a bunch of thieves. 2 unique ones. Oh, and there was a wizard in there too. We kicked the shit out of some spellcaster.
Yeah.
No good loot yet though. Really, nothing too crazy.
Oh,
else going. No refund, but your dislike really kicked in during Act 2. Maybe some mods. That's what I'm waiting for, is... because they're supposed to be releasing the mod tools, like, soonish, I think. And I'm hopeful that they'll do some interesting things with those. It's a shame that they're not releasing map editing tools for it. Because I think if they had, people would have gone ape shit for that game. Like, creativity... creatively, good God. Speaking. Okay, so we got another badge. I don't remember how many we needed. I feel like we haven't got all of them, but maybe we have. There's some Titan Grip perk that lets you two-handed weapons. In tabletop, in third edition, yes, there was Monkey Grip, which let you do that. It didn't technically let you... You couldn't, like, a greatsword is a two-handed weapon. You couldn't use a greatsword one-handed, but you could use a large-sized longsword, which was mechanically identical to a greatsword in one hand. You can count on me. And in Neverwinter Nights 2, their implementation of Monkey Grip let you dual-wield two-handed weapons, which I absolutely did. But yeah, like Cell says, generally it's actually not worth doing because you take a penalty to your attack rolls. And you'd be better off just power attacking for that value. You would get more damage on average with a two-handed weapon. That having been said, I totally ran Neverwinter Nights 2 and I had a guy that dual-wielded scythes because edgelord. I was a teenager. It excuses everything. Okay, so we need... hopefully we have both of these. What's that one? Okay, we need one more. I don't know where it is. I know we need two more, apparently. Brunhilde, get out of here. Let me interact with these fucking things. Oh, no. Okay, no, we do only need one more. All right. Just make sure I don't have anybody. Okay, we're good. We're good. So... let's see. If I were a random badge, where would I be hiding? Made it a perk for Baldur's Gate Dark Alliance too. That doesn't surprise me. I mean, it's kind of a trope at this point that, you know, big strong fighter man uses two-handed weapon with one hand. I don't think it's a bad idea or anything. Did I get the one from the ice giant? I haven't fought any ice giants. At no point have we fought frost giants yet. I think I missed an area because, like, when we were coming here, they mentioned frost giants. And I was like, we haven't even seen frost giants. So yeah, I think we gotta backtrack. I shall see to it. I mean, that makes me feel better though, because I mean, obviously we weren't meant to come here quite yet, but we've been doing okay so far. The Oubliette to Ice Tunnel. Have I been to the Oubliette? Interesting old game, by the way. Oubliette is one of the games that I'm taking inspiration from for Cutcrawler. I haven't been up here either. Oubliette was an old-ass dungeon crawler, and it ran on Plato, which was a university computer system years and years and years ago. And ooh! Oh no, these are the tarnished ones. I don't think these guys are too bad. And it was multiplayer, so you'd run around with groups of other people. But there was a DOS port that let you roll up a whole party. These things are actually quite nasty. I love how Rove's just getting in and fisting. I really appreciate his gumption. Get out of there, Rove, you fucking idiot. Acting like he's millennium, killing some tarnished. That's what they get for being uppity. Missed an area, there's some good stuff there. Ooh, good to know. Hell yeah. I'm always happy for more loot. Guys, there we go. Hello, Nori. You can stay here, I'm just looting. Nothing? Alright. Hello, Norl, I'm sorry.
I assume you have brought me more topazes to cut. Set them down and leave me to my work.
Sorry, I don't know what you're talking about.
I suppose even Marquette's goons aren't bored enough to come in here and harass me. My name is Norl. I am a gem cutter. Marquette keeps me here so I can cut gems for his master.
What's wrong with your legs?
Morcath hobbled me because I wrote a book called Misery and he really liked it. I tried to escape. I suppose I should be happy. At least he didn't cut out my tongue. Someday that bastard will get what's coming to him.
He already did. I killed him.
Justice has finally been served. Thank you for your help. I will remember you for the rest of my days.
Oh, look at him go. He's even got like a fucking gimped up walk animation. Good God, a Stephen King reference. I'm glad somebody got it. Was pretty on the nose though, admittedly. All right, so we've got a couple areas. We've got this, and we've got the Oubliette. So I'm gonna quick save and we're gonna sleep because, yeah, I don't want to deal with fatigue.
Give the word.
Huh? Is a free elf dwarf thing. You know, Svirfneblin, they're gnomes. That's literally everything but what you said, Ela. Were any more on the nose, it'd be a piercing. I've never heard that turn of phrase before, but that's a good one.
It shall be done. Duty calls.
So a bit of the TV special movie. Yep, that's what I'm referencing. Oh, shit on gnomes. Best PC race. Yeah, okay. I won't be taking questions. gnomes. My problem with gnomes is that, like, they're just kind of like a token short race to me. It's like you've got dwarves, you've got halflings, and then there's just also gnomes because reasons. Gnomes are just mutated dwarves. Dwarven freaks.
Go away. Can't Marquette's goons pick on someone else? Give old Tarnhelm a rest.
Oh, I want to pick on you.
I want you.
Oh, let's see.
I wasn't going to pick on you.
All you outsiders do is work.
I want to give these things like the voice of like the Lollipop Guild from Wizard of Oz.
All you outsiders do is work my people to death and steal the pride of Kalardaran. The only time you come down here is to have some fun kicking us around. Why don't I just knock my own teeth out and save you the trouble?
Oh, seriously, I was gonna pick on you. Why would I do that?
That's nice. Feign caring. It must give you some sort of cruel delight to see someone cheer up right before you shove their your stinky boot in their face.
Oh, God, we found Elana Ray. Gnomes are tricky little fucks. The best guys if halflings weren't fat and lazy. I love it. I think there's too many PC races. Yeah, I'm like, give me like human elf dwarf. And that's generally speaking enough for me. Yeah, okay, I'm not gonna play on.
What is this place?
It's an Oubliette, genius. It's where that deranged sadistic bastard Marquette throws Svirfneblin when we're too weak to work in the mines of the refinery. I used to work at the Great Forge between Maiden Ilmadia and her fire giants moved in to tear it apart.
Sounds like he knows how to handle his business. I like his style.
I didn't come down here to get insulted or treated like I'm someone's evil henchman.
If you're such a kindly soul, why don't you get out of here and bring us some food? My breathing isn't getting any better by choking on rock dust all the time. While you're at it, why don't you kill some salamanders at the top of the chain elevator?
I got food.
Well, I'll be damned.
Oh, that's a sack of potatoes. That sack of potatoes was worth 80,000 experience points.
I never would have expected someone to help us. You don't seem half bad to me. Perhaps you could help us with something else.
Oh, here it comes.
What do you need?
My people are located a short distance from here in a camp. The Umberhulks are having trouble finding it for now, but that won't be for long. If you can make it there, you can seek shelter. Of course, we'd appreciate it if you could defend us from the Umberhulks.
How do I get there?
Go to the northeastern corner of the pit. There's a plateau. If you walk around for a while, the hulks will eventually come looking for you. I can feel them burrowing below us even now. Once they get through, you can enter the twisting tunnel maze on the other side. Use the glowing red gems to find your way to our camp.
Why don't the Umber Hulks use the path if it's easy to follow?
Oh, that's because of the purple worms and the landmines. Actually, Umber Hulk guys can't detect red light very well. They're like shitty beetle dogs, especially when they're burrowing. They have strange clear skin on their eyes that protects them from the debris when they rush around. It's very difficult for them to detect that gem's particular tint of light. And that, children, is what we call an asspole.
All right, thanks. Well, gold leaf leveled, hell yeah.
What do you want?
Yeah, Dark Sun has pretty interesting takes on, actually, I would say all of the races. Also, I'm pretty sure it doesn't have gnomes. Actually, does Dark Sun have gnomes? I don't think it does. No, okay, I was gonna say, like, I don't remember there being any gnomes in this. That's just another point. Another point for Dark Sun. 6 level spells for Goldleaf. Alright, let's see. Let's grab another bit of armor. Let's grab... I have not been casting Holy Smite at all. Nibene wiped out all the gnomes. Ah, okay. I'm gonna give her Glyphs of Warding, because these are cleric-y fireballs. They just take a while to cast. Alright, what kind of... Oh, that's Blade Barrier. Is this the one centered on the caster? No. Oh no, yeah, it is. The caster's immobile for the duration. Dang it. Aerial Servant, Bolt of Glory. Alright, that's not amazing. Entropy Shields. Plus 6 AC, plus 2 to saving throws, and 50% resistance to electricity, fire, cold, and acid, immune to flame strike, all missile-based attacks. Wow. That is a really good defensive buff. That is a contender. False Dawn. Undead creatures suffer. So this is basically just Sunburst. But heal. We have to take heal, right? Melee. What? Any missile weapon that intersects with the disc is instantly reversed in direction, so it returns missile fire to the attackers. Yeah, so this just is like reflect projectiles. Spiritual Wrath, Wondrous Recall. Oh, this lets you bring back spells, yeah. Wondrous Recall could actually be pretty good too, but no, heal. It has to be heal. Had to be heal. Any other spell would be wrong. For Dark Sun, they had gnomes, but did a good job slaying them all.
This time,
oh, a rhinoceros beetle, nice. Oh, sad beetle noises. I'm sure we can use that shell for something, but I don't care. Brunhilde fucking crit it for 62 damage, because of course she did, because she's Brunhilde. It's Lava Haste spell. And Chaos. Because this is gonna get bad once people start getting confused. Get them, boys. Alright, who'd we lose? Fucking gold leaf. No, get out of here, guys. Get out. Just get out. Let them sit over there and, like. Look at her. Yeah, she was going there for a second. Yeah, Brunhilde has no chill. She is an incredibly dangerous melee fighter. Okay, so it said the walk around and then the tunnel would show up. Let's see in the tunnel. Unless we're just supposed to, ah! This is like incredibly hard to intuit where we can go. This is not particularly nice looking. Hey, Hurricane, good to see ya. That's a fucking god. Over here, we're supposed to, there we go.
suppose I guess.
I know we were supposed to just walk around somewhere. Good lord, that is a lot of Umber Hulks. Let's not. Yeah, the gnomes have just been hiding underground, and now they're coming back, and they're pissed.
I gotcha.
What is damn it, Vaughn. And gold leaf just standing up here all confused like. No, no.
My soul eye.
Something wrong. Watch this.
Gnomes breeding their ogre bodyguards. Yeah, I mean that's Master Blaster, right? You got to. You just got. Is that a nappy nap?
Yeah.
Get our buffs cooking.
Yeah.
Revenge for all the top shelf jokes. Oh man. Just imagine modern day gnomes just like going into a Walmart or something, and they've got like one of those little grabby hand plastic things, and that's how they get like the cans off the top shelves. Thank you for rescuing Guello from the mines. His return has bolstered our spirits. You can, if we keep out of harm's way until the Umber Hulks have passed, we will have a good chance of recovering. All right. I remember helping that dude. Nim. Who are you? Oh, you're a drow. Quit the mumbo jumbo speak common. Die, drow scum.
I don't understand what you're saying.
I apologize, honored customer. I will speak in your common tongue for our mutual convenience. I am Nim.
Show me your wares. Oh, boy.
We found the shop, guys, and they got expensive shit. Finally something to spend my money on. But first... it's interesting he won't buy some of this stuff. These gauntlets of element might, that pisses me off. That's a shame. All right, 200K, we can afford like two really nifty things. I mean, I've got almost, like I said, 200 grand. Solemn Duty, this is a katana, +3. Immune to confusion, 3% chance of decapitating an opponent on each hit. This thing's Vorpal. Except if it were actually Vorpal, it would be a 5% chance. And it has some bonuses against outer planar creatures. This versus outer planar creatures, that is purely so that we can use it against the final boss, I would bet. That's tempting. Staff of Morden's Breath. Resurrection. Really? I wonder how many charges it has. Oh, we can't steal from this shop either. Wait, no, we might be able to steal from this shop. No, no.
How may I best serve? Gladly.
No, we can't steal. Man! Why give me pickpockets if I can't use it to fucking gank shit from the shops? Cancerous bastard sword. I don't know why you even have that. You can also get rid of your old katana because your new scimitar is better. Old leaf. Yeah, he just will not buy flails for whatever reason. Weird. All right, let's see what we got here. +2 AC. Eh, bracers. These are bracers of AC 2. That's real good. The Veal of the Hollow Men. Shadow monsters once per day. Summons 1d4 shadows. So that's like a, there's that, the Horn of Valhalla, where it summons berserkers, although in this case it's just ghosty boys. 3%? Vendor trash. Or was Solemn Duty and Siege of Dragonspear, right? That would be great. Oh, and then we have spells. Oh, we have spells, but the problem is these are 7th level. I don't think we're going to get high enough level by the time we finish this to cast 7th level spells. Delayed blast fireball, you bastard. Oh, do you have darts? Oh, you have darts, and they're so expensive. You also only have 80 of them. A cage of exotic birds and a cage of squirrels? Oh, these are for the elves. Okay, sure. Why not? Grab these. Because I think I have some seeds for them, too. All right. I mean, we're buying this. We are 100% buying Solemn Duty. That's going to be Chunk's new weapon. Mystery of the Dead. The only legible words at the top of the shield read, "And what of the dead?" Immunity to Finger of Death and Power Word Kill, plus 4 AC. So this is a tower shield. I think this might be about the equivalent of what Swell currently uses. Yes, without the Thaco penalty, but also losing the resistances. I think I'm actually going to take the damage mitigations. All right, Chunk, here you go. You really didn't get to use Solemn Duties, actually, or Valiant. You can use Valiant, and you're offhand. Look at that. Fucker's two-weapon fighting has a Thaco of 1 and 4, and Swell's like, "I occasionally hit," and Brunhilde's like, "I never miss." I love video games. Yeah, we have these seeds. So we're gonna have to make a trip back to fucking Elfberg at some point here. That's okay, we gotta go and deal with the Frost Giants anyways. I would help elves. It's not so much elves as they have a garden and I like gardening. So I kinda have to. I'm honestly tempted to get this violin. Just as like something to summon garbage with, but I'm gonna get this because it's plus 2 AC and it's only 11 grand. These bracers of AC too. I think I'm gonna get these two. I think that'll do it. All right. So plus 2 AC helm he's already got with this thing. Brunhilde? Maybe? Yeah, Brunhilde's getting an upgrade. Hell yeah. God, she looks doofy. And these, bam, negative 3 AC on Devon. Okay, cool, we actually got some upgrades here. That's great, I'm very happy with that.
At your command, my sword is yours.
The AD&D has an issue with quadratic wizards, but they really did nail the practical class balance. Yeah, by and large. Yeah, that's the thing, is everybody's like, you know, a 20th level wizard is insane, and yes, they absolutely are, but I've literally never played a campaign outside of one that started at epic levels that went higher than 13th level. Talk with him, he can end a quest. All right.
It shall be done.
Isn't it dangerous being an Underdark merchant?
For many it is. However, I have been in this trade for over 400 years. I've seen my way in and out of places that no other Dark Elf has seen. You'd be surprised how powerful a single merchant can be.
You're the one that's gonna be surprised when I'm standing over your dying corpse. I'm about to do the world a favor. Good Lord, Swell, he's not a gnome.
Really? Where have you been?
Ah, well, I have seen many things and been many places. The gem mines of Thay aren't quite as frightening as some might lead you to believe. The depths of the Moon Sea aren't filled with undead. Oh, and the treasury of Dorne's Deep wasn't very secure even when it was inhabited by dwarves.
Wait, what are you getting at?
The Darthir and Dwarven artifacts produced by the so-called Time of Cooperation were too valuable to resist. Selling the artifacts to the goblinoid armies was the best business decision I ever made.
Oh my god.
Why is that?
Had so many angles to play. The stupid goblins went bankrupt just to buy artifacts that they couldn't use properly. The dwarves who were threatening to attack some drow outpost were implicated, and the Darthir slit their own throats when they decided to wage war against the goblins and the dwarves. Silly elves.
Alright. So I assume I'm supposed to murder him then? Do we pick this fight, or is that a bad move? If he's the one that caused, like, the great wars, or is he going to be like, "I'm so powerful, mage bullshit"? I don't have to. He's so based. Ah. Sort of in line with generic trends, D&D Beyond posted some statistics about 90% of campaigns end at level 10. Yeah. The knowledge is what I need. Okay. All right.
I'm not particularly fond of what you did.
Actually, we'll just leave. Okay. Now we have to figure out where to use that knowledge. I am sure that it's probably in here somewhere. Quests? No. I don't know. We'll worry about it later. Now I want to see what's in here. Then we got to go and deal with giants. Because if I don't do it now, I'm going to forget about it. Hey, Poyle. Good to see you. Hope you're doing well. Is the adventure mistreating you at all? No. No, we actually just got some nifty items from a shop. And we're just kind of poking around in a little Svirfneblin. All right, a little Svirfneblin camp here. The other things are done right. The Godlich and Elfberg can give us some good XP. Ah, okay, gotcha. Yeah, we really need to go back there. Dirty Lou. Oh God.
Welcome to Dirty Lou, sir. We have a fine selection for you today, straight from the stinking bowels of Faerun.
Why do they call you Dirty Lou?
Oh, it's because of my fondness for the ladies. I have quite a reputation when it comes to my fondness for the ladies, you see. Quite a reputation. Fondness for the ladies. Have I told you about my fondness for the ladies?
And he's like licking his lips and like making weird smacking noises all the time. Umber Hulk plate. AC2 a bit late in the game for that. Spirit essence. Oh, this is just a healing potion. Okay. Wait, what was that? Made by capturing and distilling the spirits of trolls. How the fuck does that work? Whatever. But you don't buy potions. You sell them, but y'all be asked if you want to buy them. What about magic rocks? No, nothing. My disappointment is immeasurable and my days are in. Dirty Lou!
I stand ready. You can count on me.
I'm disappointed in you. So we have something here. Okay, nothing up here. So I assume that this just leads us back here and we saw Bjorn or whatever go that way. So we're actually going to backtrack. I need to go and take care of stuff because otherwise I'm going to forget about it.
I think Dirty Lou might be getting...
He's just trying really hard to make everybody believe he's like this mega stud, and it turns out he's totally a subby boy in the bedroom. He's got like a sex dungeon, massive like chain system rigged into his ceiling. And it's also that any other race can raise him to the appropriate height. He's a jerk, but there's an item quest with him, the other seller and the mage back in the tree town. Okay. Hilda, I am so tempted to get rid of her boots of speed. The only reason I keep them on her is so that if there's a mage, I can just get her right in their face. Sex dungeons and dragons. He gets dirty all the time because the only ladies he gets, he needs to dig up. Oh! Selt coming in with the fucking fatality. Jesus Christ. Nah, no worries, Elil. Okay, so now... Where the fuck was Elfsberg's severed hand? I think Elfsberg was, yeah. Oh my God, I'm gonna have to schlep my fucking ass all the way back up this thing again. Ugh, this is terrible. Elf mage, come down here. Do all the work for me. I'm bringing back like seeds and birds and shit. Then it was, I think, up the center. Isn't there some official book for that? Shh, yeah. There was the Book of Erotic Fantasy in 3rd edition D&D. And then there was... I don't actually know what the other one is. I'm familiar with the Book of Erotic Fantasy, and like, as far as
Okay, that's it.
As far as the subject matter goes, it handles it pretty professionally, I would say. Okay, now I think it was this one to the cleric.
Getting pretty tired.
I can't believe it got. Yes, the Book of Erotic Fantasy. Yes. This, I think this is where we want to be. Because no, she wanted water. Never mind, this is the wrong place. And we brought her the holy water.
I shall see to it.
They just kind of accepted that nerds can be horny. Yeah, yeah. Fatal. No. Fatal is just a trash fire. I'm talking specifically for 3rd edition D&D. There were two porny books. Book of Erotic Fantasy is one, and I can't remember the name of the other one. But it was the one that wasn't the Book of Erotic Fantasy that had like a bunch of really super childish shit in it.
Duty calls.
Because of course. It's up here. Is it up here? Is it up here? Yes! Ha ha ha! Alright, you hold still.
I found some seeds you might be able to use.
You found some seeds, and with these I can return some beauty to this place. I'd almost never given up on seeing life here. I thank you. If you ever come across any other items to restore the Arboretum, I would be most grateful. Farewell, friends.
So I assume, is it gonna fade out and have greens? Yeah! You still look dead, but...
These squirrels look like they need a bigger place to live.
The Arboretum will serve as a pleasant home for them. Thank you. Go in peace, my friends.
Another 84,000 XP. Okay. Nope. Talk to her. There were only two in there. They've been fucking. Holy shit. Birds. They will like their new home. Their song shall serve to brighten the Arboretum. Come across anything else, I would be most grateful.
No levels from that. Ah,
to my endless disappointment. All right, do you need anything else? Is that everything? We have seeds. We have animals. Oh, I think we gave the pure water to the other person though. Rip, so this is gonna be forever stanky ground, I guess. Sorry. Nymphology, yes. That was the other one. Oh, there's more pure water. Good to know. Thank you, Hurricut.
You can count on me.
Okay, now I have to remember how to get to that fucking wizard. I remember it was a roundabout way to get to him. I think that was through here. The other one had holy water. Ah, okay. Okay.
Duty call.
The wizard's up here, and then we go out the wall. Yeah. Book of Vile Deeds. There's Book of Vile Darkness. I don't know about Book of Vile Deeds. Not familiar with that one. But if it lives up to the name, it doesn't surprise me. Yeah, there was Book of Exalted Deeds and the Book of Vile Darkness, and those were edgelord bullshit for the sake of edgelord bullshit. Although the Book of Vile Darkness has some good monsters in it. And a couple interesting spells. I like Crushing Fist of Spite, but that's because it's broken. And then there was, there was another spell in there that was like second or, it was like some low level spell, it was like maybe a second or third level spell, and it did like 3d20 damage or something. Back to you, turd. You get the water in the area with frost giants. All right, cool.
Count on me.
Yeah, the Book of Vile Darkness and the Book of Exalted Deeds were, like, I own them, but they're not books that I would consider, like, particularly great. Let's see. I wish to know more of the events that came to pass here at the hand. Now, why do you still remain? Okay, find peace. I wish no more. Trail. Continue. You wish to learn prosperity, and we're just gonna listen to all of this. Then, but furious, we questioned. We were, as to be expected, you wish to learn what century the top in the with for as the as I watched. Man, he goes on. He was angry. I was transformed into a. There we go. My punishment was to watch over the ruins of the hand of the Seldarine and its people. I gotta go. Cursed forever. Till the astrolabe was restored. This is like so ridiculously fucking bloated out. Good lord. Okay, so that was just a journal entry then. Nothing too crazy. Okay.
At your command.
Elfin Lich, he doesn't even have to pause for breath.
It shall be done.
You have returned. Oh, the next Dragon Age game. There's some other stuff I need to do. All right, I'm not going to worry about it then. That's just going to be a pain in the ass. Take me to Doran's Deep. And from here, I'm just going to leave. Hey, Worm's Tooth was the fucking... This was the salamander place. Oh, it's his daughter. Gotcha. Yeah, I'm already gone. Whatever. Not overly worried. Is it this fucking cave over here that I've been trying to get into, but I don't know how? I decided to make an Elfa Lich. You gave an arrogant bastard immortality and the ability to go on forever, and I hate you. Eh.
I am on it.
Too arrogant to die. It is this fucking cave. Oh, God. All right, I have to figure out how to get in there. Cause they were like, the bridge is too, we've got to repair it. Oh no. Where's Brynhilda? Oh, there she goes. I might have the shit to repair it now. It's been a while since I've clicked on the thing.
My sword is yours, you can count on
me. Well, can you fix the bridge? Now, go to the area the slaves are into. Okay.
It shall be done.
I can do that. I can follow directions at least. The book. Wait, I know what book you're talking about, I think. I left it on the floor. I found it after we killed all the salamanders, and I'm like, oh, this is useless, and I just left it there. I think I know what book you're talking about. Oh, let's see, I think they were over here. This fucking thing right here. It's gonna be some like bridges for dummies. Engineering manual. God fucking damn it. Dwarven engineering, it's written entirely in Dwarven. Someone has inserted translated notes in several places. Detailed analysis on the construction of suspension. We're literally gonna make a suspension bridge. Oh my lord. There's something in the elf library. Well, that sucks for the elves. I already did the walk back there once. I'm not doing it again. Happy Ghost is ready to be done with Icewind Dale. So we're gonna do this, we're gonna kick the shit out of Porkland, and then we're gonna fight John Rhys Davies. Fucking Brynhilda is stuck behind Chunk, and she's just like sitting there breathing down his neck. She's like, hurry up, move faster, dwarf, hurry up. And Chunk is just like, no. Even good games need to end. Yes. Yeah, I'm not having a bad time with this or anything like that. This is a great game. This has been a good time. It's just, I'm good. But you managed to repair it. Hey, and that leveled both Brynhilda and Rove up. Nice. Rove, what level are you? 12th level. He's going to hit 7th level spells just to spite me. I know it. I'm gonna give him quarterstaff proficiency, even though he's probably too weak to actually carry one. And Brunhilde is just increased shit kicking. Fucking -3 Thaco now. Oh, we don't have buffs running. It'll be -3 with buffs. Good lord. Alright, Rove, let's memorize some spells for you, buddy. You got some extra slots. Ooh, extra stone skin. I'm okay with that. Fifth level. I'm gonna grab a feeble mind. Sixth level. Give him Tensor's transformation. We trained him wrong as a joke. Yes, next is wizardry. Wizardry 8 will be up next. And we're going to start it tonight if we finish this and have like more than 10 minutes left, which we should. I'm probably going to give him flush to stone. Save versus spell. Save versus spell. In that case,
we have purposely trained him wrong as a joke.
I'm actually going to give him disintegrate. It's going to be more generally applicable. Random bridge wolves! I don't know where that other one went.
I'm ready to do adventuring and stuff.
Weird. Aw, oh, blessed hydration. Only water tonight. Normally I'll have like a soft drink or something to drink as well, but as I said, I was at a theme park all day and drinking far too much soda, so I need to not. A lot of problems can be solved by disintegrate and gust of wind. I wholly agree with you. I played a wizard years ago and his whole shtick was flesh to stone. But I asked the DM if instead of doing flesh to stone, I could do flesh to salt. So he'd turn people into salt, and then I'd break them up and sell them. Next, De Serrano stream went. Oh, we don't talk about those streams. Those streams are a dark time. They require ghosts to be in a dark place. Mostly playing things like La Mulana. So give me like 2 or 3 weeks with wizardry, and we'll be there.
Yeah.
There's at least one rather tough fight. I'm okay with that. I like difficult fights. Hello! That's... That is... This fight's gonna suck purely because of the trolls. Alright, let's do this. Devon, mirror image yourself just for bits and shiggles. Hey, and then chaos. Am I nervous to try Baldur's Gate 3? Not nervous, no. It's just I don't think it's going to be a game that I enjoy because it's the game seems too horny for its own good, and that does absolutely nothing for me. And Brunhilde single-handedly fighting 30 trolls with her bare hands in her underwear. Swell. Is this Chunk? Fuck off for a second. Gold Leaf? Also. There's one. I mean, I could just fireball us and really save some time here.
It is a shame that we must resort to violence.
We should survive. Ah, fuck. No fireball, no fireball, no fireball. Okay.
At your command.
Swell. You want a mod that turns off the horny? Yeah, that's where I am. Like, I've got better shit to do than deal with the developers and player base being super horny. I don't care. And The upside that I have for it, though, is that I don't know enough about 5th edition mechanics off the top of my head that when it's doing shit that's, like, rule-breaking for what 5e normally does, I won't even realize it. So I feel like that's nice. I know that was something that Celt mentioned, is that they just kind of play really fast and loose with the rules. Okay, so that's 2. God damn it. Really? Really, you fucking idiots? I tell you to walk around and you're like, I'm gonna walk right through it. I like the burning pain of Vagnazar Scorcher.
Feels really good. Especially when I can't see anymore during the retinal burn.
You can click through the horny, but not the fights. Yeah, that's the other thing that worries me, is that if all the fights turn into like they were in, Divinity Original Sin 2, where it's all just like ball buster difficulty stuff, I am not even gonna put up with that shit. Not again. Oh, Snow Troll. Vorpal hit. Okay, Chunk just decapitated that thing. I was like, what the hell just killed that thing? Because nobody deals elemental damage. What do you want? Chunk doesn't have to deal elemental damage. He deals Vorpal damage. Yeah, exactly. Like, that's how I am as well, Elil. Is, if you want your characters to have a relationship, sure. But, like, I don't need romances in video games. I do not care. I don't need a game to give me that. Why am I not allowed to tell useless customers why? Oh, useless. Yeah. If only. If only. Get out of there. Lob a fireball. Here we go. Lord. The troll micromanagement is so obnoxious. Give me options. Instructions how to do this. I don't even know what your problem is outside of you and your web developer both saying that you only see 403 forbidden. Sounds like somebody didn't set up their permissions file correctly. Let's see. Do I have any, like, random... Oh, yeah, we have another. Yeah, sorry. I'm gonna sleep after this fight. Recharge spell slots. Oh, is that a dragon, maybe? That doesn't look like a dragon, but it might be a dragon. Nope. You're gonna let me sleep, game. We're not playing. You set up the FTP account. Yeah, that's going off. Somebody call the ambulance. I don't know. I don't have the. That's why I work for myself now. I just do not have the patience for that. Oh, maybe this is a dragon. Hey, look at those hips! Black Ice Knight. That's just a thing now. People nowadays have no, they have no critical thinking skills, and they have no, God, what's it called? They don't do anything unless they're told to do it. And I see it all the time at my evening job, and it drives me insane. And they refuse to take it. Yeah, of course. So at last we meet. I am Kontik, and I greet you. You were expecting me? Oh yes, your coming was foretold to me. I have been waiting for your arrival. Foretold by whom? The goddess. She cast her gaze into the future and saw our paths cross here. Thus she bid me to journey here to await your coming.
Who is this goddess you speak of?
Why, Oral, of course. She welcomes you.
Oral the Frost Maiden. To what does she welcome me?
Your death! Yeah, to the chill of her embrace, to the cold of her bosom, to the black ice of her frozen heart. She has prepared a place of honor for the bastards who slew her chosen Lysen. Did you think you could slay a child of Oral and not feel her wrath? Die, wretched fools, die that Oral may feast on your souls!
Yeah, buddy, I don't think this is gonna end. We got... Let's see, how do I want to do this? Because I assume that this is an entryway right here and they're meant to just kind of clog him up. Brunhilde, violence. Everybody else? I guess just kind of move in and we'll see what goes on here.
Get him!
She's fucking... Yeah, that's right, buddy, you don't get no spells when Brunhilde's around. Alright. So I'm curious to see how dangerous these Ice Knights are. I assume that they're probably immune to just about any offensive spell that we'll want to really use for mind affecting stuff, because that's how this game seems to roll. Haste going. Oh, he's dead. That was quick. Vaughn, look busy with your bard song. Brunhilde's just murdering everything. Down here, and like, I want to cold these guys. Like, right here. What is required? I hope that that doesn't hit Brunhilde, because this might do a lot of damage. Or like 30. Eh, okay. I don't want to break shit, so I'll just not do anything. Yes! People never had those skills. I don't know. Some people, maybe. It's just fucking frustrating.